Hey everybody, how are you? We are into our second full week of February, and we have gone from one sporting event to another, from the Super Bowl to the Sochi Winter Olympics. Yes, it's that time of year where the world gathers to celebrate sport, and this year it is in Sochi, Russia. We have gone from Vancouver to Sochi, Russia. And as of today, I'm referring to my mini information superhighway, my iPhone, with my Wonder Woman case. We have gone from, with the medal counts, the U.S., we are now in fourth. Canada is first with 7 medals. The Netherlands is in second with 7. Norway is 7th, and we are in 4th place with 5 medals. So, you have Canada, the Netherlands, Norway, and then the U.S. So, we're hanging in there. We're doing pretty good. I think our team has done really good so far, especially with the figure skating the previous night, and I believe today our women's hockey team beat Switzerland 9-0. But for mostly this review, I want to focus on the opening ceremonies. Now, the opening ceremony for the Olympics is pretty much the biggest welcome party to the host city. You have only one chance to get it right, and you have one chance to make a lasting impression. Now, obviously, when you think of opening ceremonies, especially recently, right away your mind goes to Beijing. And how can you not right away think of Beijing? Their opening performance for the 2008 Summer Games was just incredible, and they set the bar high. So you had Beijing, and then you had Vancouver 2010 for the Winter Games. And then, of course, you had London 2012 for the Summer Games, and this year you had Sochi for the 2014 Games. Now, my verdict on the Sochi opening ceremony, I thought it was really good. Well, first off, my absolute two favorites for the opening ceremonies as of recently was Athens, Greece in 2004 for the Summer Games, and London 2012 for the Summer Games. Those two are my absolute favorites, but tying for third may be Sochi. So, now, what did I love about the Sochi opening ceremony? I loved the video introduction where it went through the Russian Cyrillic alphabet, which I'm surprised Google didn't crash from so many people probably just logging in trying to figure out what the heck each letter is in the Cyrillic alphabet. You had the letters, and you had like images of Russian icons and achievements in science, literature, things like that. I thought that was really, really cool. And of course you have the one ring forming the Olympic rings that did not want to function. That was a technical error, but, you know, hey, live TV, you you know, you get what you get. And it's funny because, you know, while the rest of the world saw that in the Russian broadcast, apparently when that one ring failed to open, they cut right away to rehearsals, to footage from the dress rehearsals, which I thought was a smooth cover-up. I thought it was really good, so I really enjoyed the opening. I thought the Parade of Nations moved really fast, which was good. Sometimes during the Summer Games, I think the Parade of Nations can kind of drag on a bit, probably because there's always more countries that participate in the Summer Games, but I thought it was really good. That's one of my favorite aspects of the Olympics, summer and winter, seeing each country march in and just be ready to participate. You see the flag bearers and you see their costumes that you're going to wear. I think of all the countries, one of my favorites that marched in was the lone athlete from Venezuela. He was really, really happy and just having a good time carrying the flag and marching in. Our team, of course, Team USA, it's always amazing seeing our team march into the stadium, and, you know, I'm not a big fan of the ugly Christmas sweater look we got saddled with in the opening ceremony, but, you know, oh well. I thought the rest of the ceremony was really good. The artistry and the beauty that was in the ceremony was incredible. You had, you know, homages to, of course, Russian history, Imperial Russia, and they did a ballet sequence with a war and peace theme. You saw the, like, modernization and, the communist era, things like that. It was just so done really, really well. And there was just so much, and there was a lot of Tchaikovsky playing, a lot of the Swan Lake theme. Another favorite sequence that I had was when, right before they began the torch relay, there was this moment where it looked like there were constellations being lit up in a darkened stadium, like just flash, flash, flash. It was just so, I had never seen anything like that before. I thought it was really, really cool, really beautiful, especially because, you know, you have, like, the dark music and you have the drum beats going, and then you hear, like, a melody of a Tchaikovsky piece, and it was just so perfectly woven in. It was really, really good. There was just so much rich artistry and beauty to it. I thought they did amazing with that. There were some moments where I kind of wish the commentators on the main primetime channel, you know which one I'm talking about, I wish they could have been a little quiet so you could have heard some of the announcements that were going on in the stadium. For example, one of the flag bearers carrying in the Olympic flag, in each opening ceremony, they have a respected group of people carry in the Olympic flag, and they're significant to each part of culture, like science, art, music, things like that. And for Sochi, being in Russia, of course, it was a class of distinguished Russians who have contributed to, you know, various parts of culture. And for me, being the lady nerd that I am, one of the people who I was really excited to see in that segment was cosmonaut Valentina Tereshkova, who was the very first woman to fly in space. So to see her be one of the flag bearers was just amazing, and I thought she looked good. I mean, the lady's in her mid-70s. I thought she looked really, really good. That was one moment where I really wished the commentators could have been a little quiet so I could have heard some of the commentary. The Olympic torch itself, the final lighting of the cauldron, I thought it was good. I think the cauldron itself, the torch, I think it was kind of plain, especially in light of how London's was, where each, where it just, you know, came together, and instead it just looks, it's not one of my favorites. But so far, all in all, I loved the ceremony. I thought it was really, really good. I had no clue what they were going to do, especially when, you know, you've been hearing so many reports on, like, hotels not being ready, things like that, really bad accommodations. So I wasn't sure what the opening ceremony was going to look like. But I think they did really, really good. And, you know, it was just artistry at its best. And I'm a big fan of artistry and pageantry, things like that. I love that when it's used right, and they did it right. So, based on how the opening ceremony went, I'm wondering how the closing ceremony is going to go and what they're going to even present for the closing ceremony. But we still have a bit to go. There's still another week left, I believe. And I just want to give kudos to that previously mentioned news network who does the main coverage for the American feed for Olympic coverage. I want to give them a kudos to adding skater Johnny Weir onto their commentary team for the skating. It is such a blast to have Johnny be one of the commentators. He's funny, he's smart, he knows his stuff, and to pair him up with Tara Lipinski is, it's such a blast to hear them do the commentaries, and you can tell they're having a good time. And it's interesting to hear it from an insider's perspective, especially the two of them being recent athletes. But it's good that they picked up Johnny Weir, and he's just so fabulous no matter what. I love him. And it's fun to hear him as a commentator, although I wish they would have kept his commentaries in the primetime slot. But, you know, well. So, you know, our U.S. team, they're doing really good. I'm very, very proud of them, and they should be proud of themselves just for making it to the Olympics. So, you know, go Team USA. And all in all, things are off to a good start so far, and, you know, I'll be back with my review of the closing ceremony when it happens, so see you guys.